Finally, it's useful to talk about what the cost of a matrix vector multiply is. So let's have a look at that. And again, here we have our archetypical matrix vector multiplication updating a vector y. So this is y becomes y plus a times x. Now, in general, you would have a matrix that's m by n. And if you write out all of the operations that need to be performed, what do you notice? Each of these terms is a multiplication. And then for each of those terms, notice that you also do an addition. So the way I like to do this is I notice, hey, look, for every element of A, I do a multiply and an add. Now, how many elements of A are there? Again, this is an m by n matrix. So there are m times n elements in the matrix. And for each of those, you do a multiply and a scalar add. So that means a total of 2 times m times n floating point operations. If anybody asks you what does a matrix vector multiply costs, if you have not given any information about that this matrix is special, and we'll look at some special matrices next week, then what you should remember is a multiply and an add for each entry in A. There are m times n entries in A, and therefore the total must be 2m times n flops, floating point operations. Another way you could look at this is say, look, if you look at the algorithm on the left, and you look at this inner statement right here, notice that 2 floating point operations are performed, a multiply and an add. Now, that loop executes n times, and then the outermost loop executes m times. So the total cost of the algorithm on the left is m times n times 2 floating point operations. On the right, you can do the exact same analysis. 2 floating point operations for the inner statement. This loop executes m times, and then this loop executes n times. So the total is 2 times m times n. So whether you interchange these two loops or not, you still perform exactly the same number of computations. Or you could look at the algorithm in flame notation. Now, what's going on here? Well, we start with an m by n matrix. Now we look at this innermost operation and notice that that's a dot product. Okay, a dot product with vectors of size n, because remember we're looking at a dot product with a row here, requires 2n computations, and then we know we do that for m rows. And the total becomes 2 times m times n floating point operations. Again, the same. If you look at the AXPE-based algorithm, the one that goes through the matrix by columns, what do we notice? Again, we have a matrix that's m by n. Now we march through the matrix by columns. This operation here is an AXPE operation, but an AXPE operation with a vector of length m requires 2 m floating point operations. You do that for each column of A. There are n of those. So the total cost is again 2 times m times n floating point operations. So in summary, all of these different algorithms all have the same cost. They just express either the order in which the computation happens differently, or they simply use a different notation.